Welcome back, folks. My name is Mead, and you're watching my Minecraft SMP Let's Play on Nishtown server featuring a whole bunch of tech mods. With me today, as usual, is Griannon.
Hey, guys.
And today we're going to do a Griannon production project. We're going to build her a room down here. We're down here next to the molten earth core. We're going to build an IC2 crop room. So I can derp around with crops and not know what I'm doing and not even have to go up those stairs. So, yeah, that's right, Mr. Garibaldi. He's in every episode now. So, what are we doing, Gree? What are we doing? What are we doing now?
We're going to go down here, and this room is not going to be so much for crossbreeding as for growing some of the crops that the resources are actually pretty useful, and you just want to keep growing those as if they were food or something. So what we're going to do is hollow out a little bit of a room down here so that I can grow those without having to go up and down those stairs that we were just talking about.
Okay. And also you won't have to use the back and home commands and irritate the crap out of Nish.
Yeah,
actually, well, that actually sounds like a good idea, though. We should be doing that.
I do. Every day. 6 or 7 times a day.
Cool.
But yeah, let's just, I'm not exactly sure how big I want this room. I guess we can just make it about, 7x7 or so for now, and then if I want to make it bigger, we can make it a little bit longer. And we can go upstairs and see what we've done on the crop so far, and that's why I threw that cropnalizer at you, so that you can look at the plants too afterwards, after we do this.
Okay.
Just make sure we don't hit the...
Yeah, it's going to be kind of close, actually. Why don't we make the... Yeah, that's one more and you'll be at it. That'll be all right. Yeah, here's where the thing starts. So you're pretty much right there.
Well, that's okay, though, because this is 3 this way, and if we can go 3 that way, then that's the 7 I was talking about.
Okay. So we're just gonna clear out this area real quick, get some resources out of it, as usual. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All kinds of good stuff down here.
7 what? What'd you get?
7 blocks to the edge of the other side.
Oh yeah, I'm the one that said 7. Duh.
And we're awfully close to lava on this side over here, too, so... Oh, we're right above it, actually.
I was about to say, I think I just heard you hit it.
Yep. So, don't dig down. Don't dig straight down. Okay. Found some gold and uranium. We found pretty much everything. Okay, so we're...
Right now we're tilling. I'm just tilling because I'm not sure where I'm going to plant anything, but it's not going to hurt.
Okay.
And because I was waiting on you.
Alright, so we're headed back to the storage room right now and getting some stuff, I guess. Not sure exactly what's going on right now. We're making something.
Okay, to make crops, you take sticks and you put them in the same exact pattern that you would put boots. Okay? You know what I'm saying? Two on the left-hand side and two on the right-hand side, up and down.
Okay.
So I just need to make a couple of those. I'm not going to need a whole ton.
Yeah, the room wasn't all that big. But you should be able to fill it up. So that's what, at least 48.
Oh, you should be recording on my side. I'm sitting here taking dirt and can't figure out why I can't make sticks.
That's why I tried to make pistons with dirt last episode. Some of y'all may have caught that.
That's good stuff. Yeah, so now I'm going to go over here. Where I've got this iron chest is where I've put some seed packets as well as some netherwort that I have gotten by crossbreeding. The netherwort actually came out by crossbreeding, and I want to plant that down here so that we can actually grow netherwort here in the overworld, because you can do that if you plant them on the crops.
Cool. Okay.
And then I've got stickweed seeds, which will give you rubber. So we're going to do that as well. And I also have cocoa. I may or may not do that. I don't think we're going to be making a whole ton of cookies, so I may not plant any cocoa plants. Or if I do, maybe just a little square of four or something like that.
Yeah, just so we'll have a few just for whatever. And we can use it for the dye as well.
That's true.
Because at some point, I'm sure we'll end up expanding our sorting system.
We're just getting the last of the stickweed seeds out. Say that five times fast. So that's what I did. I got my little bit of netherwort, four cocoa seeds, and all the stickweed seeds.
Okay.
I told you I missed that turn every time.
Okay,
oh, wow. So. My texture pack isn't showing that at all.
Not at all?
No, it's an empty spot. But I was expecting it to take four seeds like the dandelions and the roses do. And so I actually have a lot more netherwort that I can plant.
Yeah, they're showing up on mine.
The only way I knew I did it right was because now I can't see the crops anymore. The crop sticks are gone, so yeah, I think I'm going to have to check on the texture pack for this and see what's going on.
Yep.
I'm hitting the wrong buttons now. I still didn't make enough, crops, because I'm just going to plant a few more here.
Okay.
And off camera, I will just continue to make this a little bit more. Plus, the fact that I can't see those crops is kind of disconcerting to me. I don't want to step on them.
Yeah, I can imagine. But you can crouch and walk around in them, right?
Yeah, I think you can. Oops, look, weeds were growing, but we're going to get rid of them.
Yep, that's one of the things. If you just leave empty crops sitting there, the weeds can grow, and I guess they can destroy other crops next to them.
Yes, they can, very much so. And that's why I was trying to decide if I'm going to actually need a Cropmatron to keep the Weed-X going, or if I can just come in here every day and put enough on it. The ones upstairs do have, I do have the Cropmatron, as we'll see when we get up there. But I'm trying to decide. I'm thinking I may end up doing a small one like I did before I upgraded the one upstairs. I just had a little bit of power to it, and that may be what I do with this.
Okay. Yeah, we can always run the power from the other thing over there.
Yeah. But so I'm gonna just leave this for now. We'll put some more up here, and like I said, this is not for crossbreeding. That's why you don't see any cross-sticked crops. This is just to get resources. In these two cases, netherwort and rubber. And off camera, I'll fiddle with that a little bit more. See exactly what I want to do with it, and go from there. It's nighttime right now. Did you want to go upstairs? I've got it fully enclosed in glass now, so it wouldn't hurt anything. We wouldn't get any monsters.
Yeah, let's go on up there.
Okay, let's head up then.
And sheep.
And creeper.
Always with the creepers.
There's always creepers everywhere I am. And if you thought the pink pavilion wasn't pink enough, it's my temporary tent home. For the viewers, when I first got on the server, I couldn't put anything down or mine out or anything down there where Mead lives because it was protected. And so I made my little temporary home, and I was planning on taking it down, but I've grown a little fond of it, so it stays.
Yep, no reason to take it down.
Where'd you go?
Just climbed up your tent.
Oh, you climbed up the
Remember?
Tent.
Remember, smart moving.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Now you're going to climb on top of the greenhouse. All right. Let's see. These are the IC crops, and every other one is a crossbreed. Now, except for the fact that these have already grown, the crossbreeds have already grown, you would see an up and down stick, and then you would see two sideways sticks. That's how you get them to crossbreed. But since they've sat here for about an hour, hour and a half, I think they're all grown. We can take one down in just a minute. I'll show Mead how it goes, and we can put another one up. But yeah, everything's growing. So. Get your cropnalizer that I gave you.
All right.
Put that in your hot bar so you can use it.
Mm-hmm.
And where'd you go? I'm going to give you some of these. Take some crops.
Okay.
Now, you don't want to tear down any of the, or to harvest any of the crops that we already know what are. So I know because I've got this mapped out where they start, but take your cropnalizer and right click on, say, this orange plant right here, which is a pumpkin.
Okay, it tells me it's unknown.
So if it's an unknown crop, that means it is a crossbreed. I mean, from doing it a while, or you can tell that that's a pumpkin, but you don't know what the properties are going to be. Right click on this pumpkin that's right next to it.
Okay.
And you see that you get some stats with that. It says GR6, GA3, RE0, right?
Yep, that's it.
Okay, that's your growth rate, your gain rate, and your resistance to weeds. But go ahead and take that, take the, go back to the first one, and if you don't do this, but if you right-clicked on it, all you would do is harvest it, but leave the plant there. But I want you to left-click on that pumpkin.
Okay. And all I saw, I think I saw a seed bag there.
Yes, we got a seed bag and we got some pumpkins. Now take your crops and right click on those up and down crops and it'll produce the cross crops, and that will make space for us to do crossbreeding for the next time.
Okay.
So every other one of these is a crossbreed, and there's pumpkins here that we planted, then these are reeds that crossbred. This is Venomelia, which actually it produces purple dye, and I think it can produce something else, I can't remember. But it will also, if you don't harvest this one, it will cause weeds to grow. So what I said a minute ago about not harvesting the plants that you know what are, that's not true with the Venomelia. I want to not left click on it, but just right click on those when they become a mature plant to make sure that they don't let the weeds take over.
Okay.
Let me see if I got any cool plants. These blue ones over here, this is, I know I will destroy the way you say this. Oops, let's click on one that's actually a crop. The one in the middle, you can actually see the name.
Cyazint?
Yeah, and that produces cyan dye. Let's see. They're daffodils. I'm at dandelions now, but this spot right in front of me is where I first got my netherwort. And I can't tell the rhyme or reason of why I got the netherwort as opposed to why I don't get it now. Let's see.
A lot of this stuff is just random.
Oh, yeah. The reeds right now, some of these are actually stick reeds. My texture pack, I can't tell, but do you see any yellow dots on any of these reeds?
There's orange dots on both of them.
Okay, then that means both of those are stick reed plants as opposed to regular reed plants.
Yeah, the other one over here has green dots.
Oh, not the pumpkins versus the melons. That's the oranges and the greens here. The reeds.
No, this right here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, there you go. And these over here that have the brown, these are cocoa plants, and they will grow the cocoa for making the cookies. I have not gotten a hops plant yet, but I'm looking forward to getting a hops plant so we can make mead for mead.
Yeah, I have not messed with any of that yet.
And the black is blackthorn, and that does black dye. Let me give you... Let me give you something.
Yeah, I was wondering if these things would use energy crystals.
All right, go ahead and use that packet of unknown seeds in your cropnalyzer, since they can't see it if I do it. So go ahead and use it in yours.
Okay, it's pumpkin.
And you have to keep flipping through it. I think it's four times.
Okay, so this is a growth 6, gain 4, resistance 2.
For the average of what I've got, because you start with 0, 0, 0, and you can build up to 31, 31, 31. But what I've got right now, playing with this 2 or 3 times a day for, what has it been, about 4 or 5 days now, my average is only about an 8. So that's not bad. That's a 12 total. So that's a pretty good one, and I will be replacing one of my existing pumpkins with that seed packet. Something else that I that I noticed that I didn't know, and I need to do a little more research about it. And I'll be doing that before I'm going to do a full tutorial on the icy crops. And I'm going to use this world, I'm going to use my other world, and I'm going to use a test world. But I want to do a little bit more research first. And one of the things I didn't know, and it's probably because I'm not keeping enough fertilizer in my Cropmatron, but these plants will actually decrease those numbers. If my numbers were 444, I might come back and it might be a 431. And I haven't figured out exactly why. I didn't know that was possible, but that's something I'm going to be looking into. Also, if you're wondering why I have these glass above it, and it probably is also stunning the growth of my plants. But at this point, I'm a little bit derpy, and I have been known to run over my plants. So this keeps me from running over them, and you can still see through them. You can still see what it is.
Yeah, especially with the connected textures.
Yeah, with the connected textures, it looks fine. It's just I'm wondering if I know I was reading about giving your plants more room. I've got them kind of crunched up here. I'm thinking that as they get bigger, as I get bigger, the numbers get bigger, and maybe if I see that the growth has really slowed down or not, it's not increasing at all, then maybe I'll spread them out. But for right now, I'm mass producing, trying to get these numbers up, trying to get the new plants, and it's working for me right now.
Cool.
Blue, click on my Cropmatron there in the middle, and you'll notice that I am out of hydration. I'm out of fertilizer, which happens a lot, but I'm also out of hydration capsules. So I'm going to run over there and get some of those.
Okay.
I always have plenty of hydration cells and Weedex, and I'm fine on Weedex right now, but we're going to put the hydration cells in there. And then I'm going to show you one more thing, and that'll probably be all we do with the crops today, because there's not a whole lot going on yet. I just wanted everybody to see what's going on so far and just get a little update. The reason I'm out of fertilizer is because I never have enough skeleton bones. I have enough... I have enough scrap going right now with the automated system that we have put together, but I don't have enough bones.
Yeah, we need to set up that spawner, that mob trap that's over to the north up there. Then you'll have all the bones you could possibly want.
Yeah. Let's go down here to the basement area. It's really colorful.
You've been busy.
There is a reason for this room, guys. And the only one I can show you, because the only one I've really done right now, come over here and look up. You'll see that there is one piece of iron underneath the top layer. And why that is, there is a special plant. It's kind of hard to get, and it's called Ferru, I think it is, F-E-R-R-U. And for you to even have a chance to get that plant, you have to have an iron ore beneath the block of dirt that the plant is planted on. So that one's there. I'm going to put a few more out there as well. I just haven't done it yet. But that's what this is so I can see what I'm doing. There's not three blocks of dirt right now, but I'm going to be putting three blocks of dirt, as you see me doing right this minute, under all of them. And I need to plant, again, some iron ore as well as some gold ore, because there's one called, I think it's Aurealis or something like that, that also grows with the gold ore. But both of those are very rare, so when we get them, I'll be pretty excited.
Cool.
That's about it for now, and I'll be letting y'all know when I get new plants in and see what's happening, see if we get some big numbers.
All right. Griannon Green Thumb.
Yeah, only in game. You can tell it's a fantasy game because in real life, I've been known to kill an air fern.
Isn't that the one that's just the dead coral that they spray paint green?
No. No.
You're not that bad.
No, but I imagine if it was possible, I would have killed one by now, yeah. But it's not much better than that. It really is supposed to just sit there and stay alive, and I managed to kill it. I got hairspray on it or something, I don't know. All right, so what are we gonna do now?
All right, I think we're going to wrap up the episode because yeah, I don't know if either of us want to get into doing anything else tonight, which it could take quite a while, but we'll save the next project for next time. And we'll call this an episode, I believe.
Sounds good. I'll be doing some mining off camera, make sure we have everything that we need to finish up the system.
Yeah, we were going to do the sorting system tonight, and we realized that we didn't have nearly enough flax seeds to make paint for the RP tubes. And so that's why we're doing this instead tonight. But next time we should have enough for we should have enough for the paint, and we'll be finishing up that sorting system. So in the meantime, this is you are.
I was waiting for you to go first. Hi, I'm not hi, we're leaving.
We're leaving.
Wow, let's close on a derpy note, right?
That's right.
Well, bye, y'all. I'm Grianon.
And I'm Mead. And we'll talk to y'all later. Bye bye.
Bye-bye.